The last 2 years have obviously been a very difficult time for dairy, but we are now seeing prices recover, farm enterprises starting to get back into profitability. And I want us to now use the opportunity of the years ahead to focus on the opportunities and to change things for the better so that next time we encounter problems, there's more resilience to deal with it. I think there's real opportunities to grow our exports. We know that demand, long-term trend, is growing by around 2% a year, and so we need to continue to open overseas markets in countries like China, the US and Brazil for some of our dairy products. I also want us to do more on risk management. I think there is great potential for using things like the futures market so that we can help farmers mitigate and manage risk looking into the future. And finally, I think there's a big issue around fairness in the supply chain, looking at whether we can improve transparency on pricing, looking again at that dairy supply chain code so that the industry is better placed next time we encounter difficulties.
My overall message to dairy farmers for the next 12 months is one of collaboration. That we work together to improve the conditions of the industry and farming, and that we work closer to basically meet the new demands of the British shopper and the customers here in the UK. In the next 12 months, there will arise new opportunities and new market possibilities. But we will also be facing with additional risk and potentially less access to markets that are closer to home. I think it's more important now than ever that farmers and industry speak with one voice while our country is negotiating the best exit deal out of the EU. In Arla, we have a very ambitious 2020 strategy, where we, among other things, want to make the Arla brand a household brand. We want to work with farmers and the farming industry to make that happen. With milk consumption declining across most European countries between 2% and 4%, it's more important than ever that we as an industry innovate in dairy. We see consumers being more focused at animal welfare, sustainability, free from products. So we need to come together and create new solutions for consumers around health, innovation, sustainability, and animal welfare. For me, that goes to the heart of our vision, which is becoming champions of British dairy. I am personally excited about working closer together with you on capitalizing on these opportunities in the future.
Hi, I'm Rob Hutchison, the Agriculture Director at Muller. At Muller, we believe there's a bright future for dairy farming in the UK. Following the acquisition of the Dairycrest Dairies business last year, we're investing a further £100 million across our UK sites to increase operational efficiencies and develop the capability to create a new generation of added value dairy products. This investment will utilise British milk and at the same time reduce the UK's reliance on imported dairy products. There are risks ahead with uncertainty and volatility, and we'll work closely with our farmers to understand these challenges to ensure we create a sustainable and bright future for our dairy farmers. Thank you.
Alors, je suis Thierry Roquefeuil, président du groupe lait du Copa. Je suis producteur de lait en France et président des producteurs de lait français depuis 2012. Tard en termes de réaction. Les outils qui sont mis à disposition des éleveurs arrivent trop tard dans la crise. Le niveau de prix, même s'il est en train de progresser, n'est pas suffisant pour que les producteurs de lait gagnent de l'argent en étant producteurs de lait. Et donc ça, c'est quelque chose sur lequel je vais travailler avec l'équipe du groupe lait, avec les deux vice-présidents qui ont été élus ce jour, et bien sûr avec l'ensemble des autres pays qui sont sur la même longueur d'onde, c'est-à-dire il n'y a pas de divergence au sein du COPA sur l'analyse. Il peut y avoir des choses qui divergent dans la finalité de nos débats, mais c'est mon rôle aujourd'hui en tant que président du groupe lait du Copa de trouver une stratégie claire pour le Copa, une stratégie que je porterai à la Commission européenne et à l'ensemble des élus européens au niveau du Parlement européen. Et c'est en cet état d'esprit que nous avons continué nos débats, notamment sur la chaîne alimentaire, sur les travaux que nous avons amenés sur ce dossier-là, qui mérite qu'avec plus de 85% du lait consommé sur le marché européen, nous puissions avoir une rémunération et une valorisation supplémentaire sur ce marché européen, parce que c'est quand même la base de notre production qui est consommée en Europe, même si de 12 à 15% de notre production est aujourd'hui exportée hors de nos frontières. Ça, c'est un autre objectif, l'exportation, pour continuer à avoir une Europe dynamique, une Europe qui, demain, sera l'endroit où bon nombre de pays viendront chercher de la production laitière, parce qu'on sait, on le sait déjà, certains pays dans le monde n'auront pas la capacité d'avoir la production nécessaire aux besoins de leur population. Donc voilà, c'est à la fois un constat d'éléments difficiles actuellement que nous avons à traverser à travers cette crise depuis 2 ans, des constats qui vont nous permettre de bâtir l'avenir, mais aussi de se dire entre nous qu'il y a une dynamique nécessaire à avoir au niveau du COPA, parce que les producteurs de lait que nous représentons ici, à travers le COPA, mais aussi la COGECA, attendent de nous des positions fermes pour défendre l'intérêt de la filière laitière européenne.
Over the next 12 months, we will see a further stabilization of the milk markets, despite the sales out of intervention of S&P by the European Commission. And we will also work all together to define the future direction of the new common agricultural policy in Europe. And we do hope that the UK dairy industry will be part of that process, because we need your input. After all, the common agricultural policy in Europe will be the baseline or the benchmark when it comes to define your UK national framework for the dairy and agricultural policy of the future. At EU level, we always value the input in the policy debates from the United Kingdom. The UK is always and was always present in those debates, and I use this opportunity to say thank you to Mr. Mansell Raymond for his dairy commitment in Wales, in the United Kingdom, in Europe and beyond. We very much value the cooperation with the National Farmers Union and your Brussels team. You and your industry are a dynamic part of our lactosphere in Europe. The only country of the EU where the number of milk farms has been stable over the last years, and where milk is sought after by the processing industry. When asked about the main ingredient for success for the British dairy farmers in Brexit times, the answer is simple: performant processors that know how to make most out of your milk, that know how to add value in the European market and at your national markets. I wish you a fruitful conference, and we are looking forward to cooperating in the future. Thank you.
I'm George Gordon. I'm Managing Director of LKL Services Limited. I farm in Wiltshire and an NFU member. The point I want to make is to protect the dairy farming sector. I think it's absolutely vital that members lobby their MPs and others and anyone who listen, so that we've got some arrangements post-Brexit to continue to have access to Eastern European labour. The industry is becoming increasingly dependent on it. It's very important, particularly to larger dairy farms. And whilst we've still got work to do and we're doing good things, but we need to do more in attracting young people from the UK and retaining the talent we've got, we cannot afford to be without access to Eastern European or third party country labour. If need be politically, I think there could be a scheme where we only take people to this country if they've got a definite job lined up, and even that they can't stay after that job ends. But we cannot afford to lose access to that labour source completely. Otherwise, we will not be able to sustain the size of a dairy industry in the UK that we've got today. Thank you and good luck.
I'm Gwyn Jones, Chairman of AHDB Dairy Board, and I'm delighted to have this opportunity to send a message to this year's NFU conference. The removal of milk quotas has exposed dairy farmers to greater market volatility. While costs of production have come down of late, we need to do more to learn from the best dairy farmers across the world and prepare ourselves for the effects of Brexit. AHDB Dairy Strategy over the next 3 years will focus on providing the tools and skills to help dairy farmers increase productivity in areas such as feed conversion, young stock production, herd replacements, endemic disease and genetics, to name a few. The strategy also places emphasis on developing and supporting long-term decisions on farm to mitigate the worst effects of volatility, and developing business skills in areas such as risk management and getting the best from milk contracts. Building on the trust and reputation to increase value and demand for British milk and dairy products is also a significant priority. Working with Dairy UK and its processor members, market development work over the next 3 years will focus on promoting the essential role of dairy as part of a healthy diet and lifestyle and a range of export activities. This is all underpinned by AHDB's redefined purpose, which is about inspiring farmers, growers and the industry to succeed in a rapidly changing world. I wish you all the best for a successful year and hope you enjoy the rest of the conference.